It is 27 minutes after 9. Thanks for being with us on Live at 9. And if you have a need for speed, the Memphis International Raceway is the place to be this weekend. It's the Memphis 150.
That it is. And behind the wheel, you'll see these two NASCAR drivers hoping to drive away with a win, Ruben Garcia Jr. and Chase Cabre. Good morning, gentlemen. Welcome to Live at 9.
Good
glad to have you here.
Thanks for having us.
Ruben, let's start with you. What got you into racing?
Well, it started with my dad because he used to race before I was even born. So racing was in my family since I was very, very little. I remember I used to go to his shop or to the races with him. So I started racing go-karts at the age of 5.
Wow. Oh, wow.
And then I started growing from there.
And did your mother always buy into this?
I think when she knew I was a male and my dad used to race, she just gave up. She said, go ahead, there's not much I can do at this point.
Chase, what's your story?
My dad raced as well. He raced motocross and got my older brother into motocross, and then I started racing motocross, and we traveled around doing that, and then that kind of got too dangerous. We went on to four wheels and kind of dimmed it down, but not so much.
Because motocross is bike, right? So you don't have anything around you.
Yeah, so you're on a motorcycle. You're strapped in a seat. So a little bit safer, but not much.
Not that much. Guys, take us inside. What is that feeling like, though? Kind of walk us through it. What goes through your mind? What is the feeling of exhilaration like for you?
Well, it's pretty cool because there's a lot of anxiety and nervous right before the race. Because all we want to go is like just go green and start the race. And a lot of planning and stuff you usually do with your team, but almost never you go with the same plan because it changes so much throughout the race.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So there's a lot of anxiety before the green flag drops. But once the green flag drops, it's game on. You stay focused and it's just trying to do your best, trying to stick to your strategy and talk to your crew chief to make your car better during the pit stops and a lot of stuff going on.
So you guys are teammates, but you're also rivals because you won last year. Congratulations.
Thank
at
you.
This at Millington.
Yep.
You want to knock that off,
yeah, we're
right?
trying to stop the repeat.
You're trying to stop the repeat.
So
like
as
that.
A team, though, because you're teammates, so how do you share a little bit of strategy, but you don't want him to know everything you're going to do and vice versa, right? So how do you balance
it's
that?
It's tough. I mean, as teammates, we tend to work together on practice days. So today we'll be at the track testing all day, and then tomorrow we have our practice and qualifying race. But it's kind of tough to play the teammate role as well as yourself. So we're all going after the same goal, but it is nice to have somebody to kind of say, hey, you know, this is what I was feeling out there. Were you feeling the same
thing?
Because other competitors you don't get a chance to really talk about that much with. So to have a teammate to kind of bounce ideas off of is nice. So it's a little bit different kind of teammate role as you would say a football teammate is where you're going after the same goal. We're going after the same goal, but for
so you're not going to give him all your good stuff, right? You're keeping something back.
I think we work really good at it because two minds work better than one. And if we work together to make both of our cars better, instead of battling for, fifth and sixth, we can maybe be battling for the win. So overall, it's a good work for us. And we usually work together throughout the race, and we know that for the last 15 or 20 laps, it's game on and just let the best one win.
No doubt about it. Everybody knows about the popularity of NASCAR, especially these days, but what about diversity coming into NASCAR as well? Is that important to both of you?
Yeah.
And why so?
Yeah, I feel it's great because NASCAR has been growing a lot lately, like in the last 10 years, I would say. It got to a point where it's an international sport. They not just race in the United States, they race in Mexico, Canada, and Europe. So to diversify their primary series here in the United States, it's very, very important to bring fans from all over the world and start to get attention from different countries to let their divisions outside the United States keep growing.
Right, Chase, how do you see that?
Yeah, absolutely. He said it best, and he has a really good viewpoint on it, being that he races in the Mexico series as well. And through the Drive for Diversity class that me and Ruben are both a part of, they've given a platform to a whole different side from what you would consider your typical NASCAR driver. So it's really opened doors for a lot of people, opened doors for myself and Ruben, and forever grateful for it.
Yeah, it'll grow the fan base astronomically.
Absolutely. Guys, we appreciate you being here. Drivers. We put the information on the screen.
Thank you.
May the best driver win.
And still remain friends at that.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, guys.
For
glad to have you here.